Hi everybody, my name is Bree and welcome back to my channel, Bree's Arts. All right, everybody, I'm so excited for today's video because we are jumping into some brand new fall decor DIYs. Now, you guys know how much I absolutely love doing fall decor DIYs, and this week we're gonna tackle some really elegant, beautiful pumpkins. Now, of course, most of the things that I'm using for today's projects are from the Dollar Tree, from Dollarama. I, you know, threw in some solo wood flowers as well. And with all of that being said, you guys, let's get into the first DIY. All right, everybody, here we go with DIY number one. And we are going to use one of these white styrofoam pumpkins. I got it at the Dollar Tree. I just took off the stem there. It's just attached with a toothpick. And we are going to chablouer, paint it up with our Nantucket blue chalk paint from Folk Art. It is my absolute favorite color. And I'm just taking a little bit of white chalk paint. This is the Rust-Oleum Linen White and my chippy brush. And we are just going to distress this down just a little bit, just to bring out, you know, some of the details there. I didn't want it just to remain completely blue. I love to distress my pumpkins here just to make them look a little bit more interesting. And brush, 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 brush. With my chippy brush and a little bit more. And if you go a little heavy-handed, that's okay, because you can always go over it with your base color as well, just until your eyes are happy. And so this doily, I have a whole box of doilies from my great grandmother. So I pulled one of them out here and I just hot glued it on the top there, and then I'm just going to go around all of the details here to hot glue that to this pumpkin. And of course, you guys, if you don't have doilies from your great grandmother, that's okay. That's what thrift stores are for. So head on down to Double V Boutique or go to, you know, Savers or Salvation Army, like wherever you can find some thrifted items and grab some doilies, because I love how this is coming together. Isn't it so pretty and elegant? I love it. And so I just grabbed one of those little wood stems from the Dollar Tree. They come in a package. You can also go out in your yard if you want to grab some wood for your peduncle of your pumpkin. And then I got these beads from the Dollar Tree. I've never seen them before. I think they're new, but that's a lot of beads for $1.50, you guys. So rock and roll, let's go. And these ones actually have these little metal leaves on them. I thought that they were so pretty. So I'm just going to kind of dismantle this string of beads here and we're going to place them on the pumpkin. So you can see, I didn't know exactly what I was gonna do. So I just kind of like fiddle around a little bit and, you know, trying to figure out what my plan is. And I was having trouble with my scissors, so I ended up using my wire cutters on the strings of these beads as well. You know, just whatever's within arm's reach. And so what I decided to do, I really loved those burgundy beads and I thought they looked really pretty with the blue. So I am stringing, I believe it's four on one of the strings with the leaf at the end. And then we're just going to tie that around the peduncle there. Eventually, I wanted to get it to a specific length, obviously, when I was looking at it. So, you know, fiddle, fiddle, fiddle. And I've had a few subscribers ask me to put, like at the beginning of my DIYs, to make a list of all of the things that I'm going to be using in the DIYs. You guys, when I sit at my craft table, I have an idea of what I'm going to do, but I really don't know exactly how it's going to come together. So, and sometimes I just sit and I just look at things for like 20 minutes and, you know, rack my brain as to exactly what's going to happen. So I wish I was that efficient. I 100% am not. So you can see here that I did another string with the leaf at the end, and then I just used like two beads there, and I'm just using my hot glue gun because I didn't have enough string to tie it around, and I'm just adhering it that way. And just like that. I love the burgundy and the blue together. And so here I just grabbed a few, you know, here, see what I mean? Like I just fiddle around, try to figure out exactly what it is that I'm going to do, what is going to make my eyes happy in that moment. And so I'm just grabbing some solo wood flowers here, and we are going to see, there's another one. I'm just fiddling around. So I decided on this little rose here for the top of the pumpkin. And there we go. Isn't it so pretty? Oh, I think it just turned out so, so gorgeous. And of course, you know, have to add one more solo wood flower onto the top just to finish this off. And that is it, you guys. Oh, I love this. Let me know down in the comments what you think. Alright, you guys, and here we go with DIY number two. Alright, I am going to use this beautiful little vase. I think it's called a rose bowl. And I'm just going to take some of this braided rope that I get off of Amazon, and I'm just going to use some hot glue and put that on the one side of this rose bowl. So just a tiny little bit of hot glue, go around the side, and there we go. And then we're gonna do that on the opposite side as well. So just clipped it off there, hot glue it on the bottom of the bowl, and then on the rim of the bowl, just like that. And then around, I guess I did it opposite to the bottom of the bowl. And we are going to do that 6 times. So we're, you know, gonna divide it so that there are 6 strands of this rope on this bowl here. So again, hot glue on the bottom of the bowl, take it down, measure that off, give it a snip, and hot glue that. And again, we're gonna have 6 strings going all the way around this bowl here. And now I am taking some of this wired jute. I believe I got this, it's either Dollar Tree or Dollarama, you guys. I think it was Dollar Tree, but I'm not 100% sure. You can always find a whole bunch of different wired jutes at a lot of different stores. And I'm just going to create a peduncle by, you know, just wrapping this around, kind of, it looks kind of like a spring, I guess, but then wrapping it around and around and around, you can see there, and then going up the stem and then back down the stem. So it looks like really kind of, you know, whimsical and rustic. I think it's very, very cute. I did this on some other pumpkins that I did last year as well. You can find that in my fall compilation video that I posted last week. And so I'm just going to take some hot glue and put my peduncle on the bottom of the bowl, which is obviously now the top. Because we're making a pumpkin. And so I got this beautiful flower pick. These are from the Dollar Tree. And again, you can see how I just kind of, you know, fiddle around, kind of choose the things that I want to place on the top here. And I decided to use that little pumpkin and the small flower there. And we are just going to take off the leaves there, take off the stem, glue those together, and then we're gonna glue that right onto this glass rose bowl here. So just, you know, positioning, and then using some hot glue, we're just going to attach that onto the top of this pumpkin. And then of course, doing the same thing with that flower as well. So just a little bit of hot glue, placing that on there. And there we go. And of course we have to do just one more on the other side because we want to make sure that all of those ropes have been covered right on the top of the pumpkin there. So just using my hot glue again and another little flower, and there we go. And here you can see that I just grabbed a few of those wooden beads and put them on some string and hot glued that to the top of the pumpkin as well. I lost a little bit of footage, but I did end up putting this on top of a plate that I got from the Dollar Tree with a candle underneath, and it looks so pretty, you guys. Let me know what you think. All right, you guys, I really hope that you're enjoying today's projects, and I just wanted to pop in here really quickly to remind you that if you like home decor on a budget, stuff that looks super high-end and your friends are like, where'd you get that? And you made it yourself out of stuff from the dollar store, then you have come to the right place. So make sure that you tap that like button, make sure you subscribe, and make sure that your notification bell is set to all so that you don't miss any of my videos. And of course, you guys, share, 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 because YouTube loves that and it really, really puts my video out there for more people to enjoy. And of course, just like every other video, you guys, oh, I want to give a big shout out to my breezers out there, my wonderful community, all of my old subscribers, my new subscribers, and everybody in between. You guys know how much I absolutely love you. I love the comments that you write on my videos. Oh, I feel the love and it's so good to be back. So, mwah, I love you so much. And with all of that being said, let's get back into those DIYs. All right, and jumping into DIY number 3. All right, I love this one, you guys. So I'm taking this hexagonal, I believe it's a hexagon, little decor piece that I found at the Dollar Tree. And I'm just going to take some macrame cord and hot glue that around, like on the top of this. And we are just going to wrap the macrame cord around and around and around and around. You'll see that I do take quite a bit of it. And we're gonna wrap it around and around and around the top of this, I don't know, candle holder, I guess it is. And just wrap and wrap and wrap and wrap until we get to the end there. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna go across and then inside the two brass kind of bars, and then come back around and go inside, and then come back around and go through inside. I will kind of zoom in on exactly what it is that I'm doing, but wrap around and go like under, and then over top and under, and then through and over top and under. So you can kind of see this close up here, over the top and through and under, and under and over the top and through, and under and over the top and through. And so we're just kind of weaving this all the way down to the very bottom of this candle holder. This turns out so, so pretty. This one, I'm gonna say is my favorite in this video, but you know, you be the judge. So as we get to the bottom here, I'm just going to grab a little bit of hot glue and we are going to adhere that to the bottom so that we complete our little, you know, macrame kind of looking portion of this candle holder. And just hot glue that into place and we are good to go. Now, you guys, don't come at me. I could not find my finger protectors, okay? So don't worry. You know, I didn't burn myself or anything, but wear your finger protectors. Do as I say, not as I do. And so here again, I am using that same pick that I got at the Dollar Tree, and using the big flower from that pick, I'm just going to hot glue that to the side here. And I decided to put it on the same side as where the macrame cord was. I only wanted to do half of it because I really actually like the brass look there. So I didn't want to completely cover it up. Now, if you want to though, you could do this on both sides. You could do different colors. You could use yarn if you want to. Oh my goodness. You could do it in like traditional fall colors if you wanted to. That would be absolutely beautiful. And of course, you can see there that I did grab a couple more of my solo wood flowers, and I'm just hot gluing those into place. And then a final touch, I just grabbed one of those, like that little pumpkin that's off of that pick as well, and I just threw it into the candle holder there, and good to go. Now, of course, this is a pumpkin, you guys, so we do need a peduncle. And I just grabbed another one of those sticks from the package that you get at the Dollar Tree, and I just hot glued that to the center of the top there. And then I do grab some more of that wired jute. This is a different color. And we're just going to make the little spindly bits on the pumpkin here. So I believe this is slightly out of frame, but I just grab a pencil and we're just gonna wrap, make these little curly cues. And we're gonna do that to the other side as well. Wrap. All the way around, and then clip off the excess, and we're just going to put that around the stem there. I love this wired jute too because it's so easy to manipulate. It's fantastic. And you guys, that is it for this cute little pumpkin. Don't you think it's so beautiful? Oh, just wait, one more thing. Hold the phone. So I do grab some of these little, I guess, pip berries. They're from a pick from Dollar Tree from, I believe it was last year. And we're just gonna hot glue that to the top, and then we're done. We couldn't go without putting something on the top there. It's so pretty. Last one, you guys, DIY number 4. Okay, so I am taking these pumpkin wreath forms from the Dollar Tree, and I have a couple of different kind of sizes of them. I don't know if I just got them in different years or what the deal was with that, but make sure that when you do this project that you do choose the wire forms that are very similar. And I just grabbed one of these absolutely beautiful tea towels from the Dollar Tree as well. And I am just going to go around and hot glue that tea towel to this wire form here. So just go all the way around, pulling pretty tight as I go. So I'll do the bottom, I adhere the bottom, and then I believe I go to the sides, right? Like make sure that you have enough material to get, you know, all the way to the top. And yeah, and then we'll wrap the sides. So this just makes it a little bit easier so you know exactly what you're working with. So adhere the two sides together, and then we'll do that. And then of course you would go around the rest of the pumpkin and just do all of your hot gluing all the way around. Make sure you're pulling nice and tight, but not too tight because you will kind of deform the pumpkin shape, right? And so here you can see I'm just going to place the other pumpkin wreath over top, and I'm just using some zip ties to attach these together. So really easy through this this tea towel. I just pierced right through, and you can't even see them with the finished product. Like, no one would ever know that this was held together with zip ties. So I did, you know, all the way around. I just, you know, attached a few of those zip ties around. And now, of course, we are going to cover the entire peduncle with some jute string. So just going around and around, hot gluing as I go, and wrapping those the stem all the way to the top there. There we go. And finishing it off on the top, and we are good to go. Just like that, you guys. Easy. It's so pretty. Isn't this so pretty? And you guys, I know I have seen multiple different versions of this pumpkin. I just think it's really pretty, and I wanted to use that tea towel because I just thought it was so nice and it really fit in with my theme. You know that I love blue. Blue is my favorite color. Blue is beautiful for the fall. So I just wanted to do one for my front door. And of course, we're gonna take some of the jute cord here, and we're going to go around the outside just as a finishing touch. So I do this twice. I go around first on the edge, and then I will go around a second time just to make sure that everything, you know, is nice and neat and tidy and everything like that. So there's the first pass going all the way around, and you can still see the wire on that side. But then of course we are going to go one more time around on the inside so that we cover that wire completely up on the exterior of the pumpkin. And finished off. All right, beautiful. And I just went on the back. I wanted just to clean it up just a little bit once the hot glue had actually set, and going around, just clipping off the excess of that tea towel, and then we're good to go there. So pretty. So I just grabbed some lamb's ear. I actually found lamb's ear at the Dollar Tree, you guys, and it's really, really good quality. I think it's so nice. And so all I'm doing here is just feeding another zip tie through the jute there and just attaching the lamb's ear that way, and then just clipping off the excess of that stem there and just hot gluing a little bit just to keep it nice and secure, using another one of those picks from the Dollar Tree and a couple, and a daisy. I think that daisy is also from the Dollar Tree. It's probably from the spring, and just hot gluing those into place. And then I think I do clip off a few of the petals of that, yes I do, of that white flower. They just weren't sitting properly, so I just, you know, snipped them off. And you guys, that is it. It's so pretty. Right, everybody, that is it for these beautiful, elegant DIYs. I just love doing fall decor. And of course, you guys, if you want to do different colors, absolutely do whatever inspires you. Do whatever color palette you want. I love blue, so you know my fall decor is blue, but you do you. Like, I can't get over how pretty that pumpkin is. I just think it's so gorgeous. But of course, as always, you guys, let me know which one of these was your favorite, and let me know what colors you're using for fall this year. And as always, you guys, I appreciate you watching and commenting down below. And if you like what you see, do me a solid. Tap that like button, maybe subscribe, tell your friends, you know, all of that jazz. Stay tuned for the gag reel. Bye, guys.
You guys know how much I absolutely love doing fall decor, and we're gonna tackle some really elegant, beautiful, easy, inexpensive pumpkins. Is that too many adjectives?
It's been very descriptive.
All right, you guys, I hope that you're enjoying. I hope. I went up like 3 octaves. All right, you guys, I really hope that you're enjoying today's pumpkin video. And I'm just popping in here really quickly to remind you that if you like home decor on a budget, stuff that looks super I don't know if that made sense. Did that make sense? It may not have made sense.
Take two.
Brand new. Fall decor. Let's get back into those DIYs. Should I try that approach? Yeah, Breeze lost it. That's what the comments will say. Breeze lost it. Mm-hmm.